Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So you probably clicked on this video because you're either struggling to get work experience for medical school or you just wanted some ideas about how to go about getting work experience and where to go and what to do. So a little about me, I'm a 29-year-old doctor who's now working as a GP trainee. Can you believe it? I'm now an ST1 and I was only an FY2 a couple of weeks ago. So when you're applying to medical school, as you'd know, volunteering work and work experience is very important. Now, these terms get used interchangeably, but actually they're quite different. So when we're talking about volunteering work, we're talking about time that you set aside in a non-medical setting where you don't get paid to gain experience. So these can be charity events, these can be extracurricular sort of activities that you do, teaching sessions, mentoring groups, anything that basically helps improve your leadership skills, your teamwork skills, your time management skills, your patience, your communication. And actually volunteering work in that aspect is more important than work experience. That basically when I was doing my medical school interviews, I had more to talk about my volunteering work rather than work experience, if that makes sense. But the reason why work experience is so critical for medical schools is that, believe it or not, it takes up a lot of money and time to train up one person to become a doctor. I think I was told it costs about $250,000 to train one person through medical school, through the NHS, and to get them to qualify as an FY1. So if you look at that, it's very disappointing if you go into medicine not knowing what it's about, not knowing the life of a doctor and the struggles and the rotas and the pay, and either dropping out halfway through the degree or getting to the end of the degree, regretting your choice and then doing something different. So that's why medical schools put so much emphasis on work experience. And I did a few things that I'll talk to you about, but I'm just going to give you an overview on what to do and the best ways to get work experience, because we all know the struggles. So when we talk about work experience, a lot of people think about doctors and hospital work. And I think that's where the biggest fall is, because there is so much more to the medical field than just doctors and hospitals. When you're thinking about applying to places to do work experience, yes, think about hospitals, but also think about places like care homes, nursing homes, clinics for physiotherapists, and even working with paramedics. With hospitals, obviously you want to probably go to your local hospital. It's going to be closer, it's going to be easier for you to get to. The best way to go about that is initially, call HR. HR deal with work experience students, and some hospitals have work experience sort of placements where they have a structured time frame for you to come in for a week. You get a timetable, you get given clinics that you're going to go to, surgeries that you're going to attend, and it's all very sort of set up for you. But these usually get filled up very quickly and it's very difficult to get them, and admin staff have got so much going on during the day, they actually don't really bother so much with that sort of stuff. The best way to do it is to physically go into the hospital, cut out the calling, cut out the emailing, go straight to the HR department, introduce yourself. When they've got a face to a name, it's easier for them to connect with you. It's easier for them to sort of get things done for you. So that should be your first point of call. And then the second thing to do is you can go through the hospital's directory, find a consultant or staff member that you want to shadow and send them an email directly. So the email might not be theirs, it might be their secretary's, and they might have some phone numbers, which probably for their secretaries, and give them a ring and just be very polite and say, look, I'm an aspiring doctor, I'm really struggling to get work experience. Could I please just shadow for a couple of days in either his clinic or the ward that he works on? And that's usually a much quicker streamlined route. That clinician is basically responsible for you. The only downside to that would be that you're with that one person only, as they're responsible for you. So the experiences that you may get may be limited, but nonetheless, it's a really useful experience. The third thing to do, if you can, if you're ever in a situation where you end up on a ward, you're visiting family member or anything, just go up to the matron or the sister in charge and just say, look, I really want to do some work experience. Would I be able to come in for a couple of days next week, for example, and just shadow and watch? And if they do give you the opportunity, try and shadow people like nurses, get to know what they do for their work, physiotherapists, the pharmacists, the healthcare assistants, and of course the doctors to get a general idea of what's going on. The way I got my work experience, believe it or not, from hospital is I ended up going to a hospital as a volunteer. So they ended up hiring me to do some patient survey. So I was doing that, and then also I was keeping an eye out on the doctor's rooms and clinics and so on. So when I had a break, I just went up to one of the rooms and I said, look, I'm actually here because I want work experience, and I was wondering if I could sit for a couple of hours with you just to see what you do and how the clinic runs and your job as a doctor within this clinic. And the doctor there was very nice. He was like, yeah, of course, just pull up a chair, sit in the corner. And with every patient that came in, he asked if it was okay for me to sit in, and I think nearly all of them, or all of them, said yes. So I observed the clinic for a couple of hours, went back outside, did more of my surveys, and then went back to hand in my iPad, and I got my volunteering work and I got my work experience. Two birds with one stone. So there's lots of opportunities there. You just need to go out and find them. I know it can be quite daunting when you're going into a big environment and being a 17, 18 year old looking up to doctors who are all in their like shirts and everything. It's quite nerve-wracking and you feel shy. But if you really want to do medicine, you want to be a doctor, you have to be confident. You have to go in there and just talk to them and just see. You're not going to lose anything. Worst comes worst, they're just going to say, no, sorry. And then that's it. So the second place you can go to your GP. So hospital medicine is what most people think a doctor does, and they forget the community, they forget the GP. And that's actually a much better work experience I found when I was there. I went the conventional route. I called and emailed the admin team for my GP practice, and they were like, no, we don't do work experience, and they just kept batting me away and they just weren't interested. So what did I do? I booked an appointment with my GP, and I think I said something when they said, why are you coming in? I said it was a personal issue. And it was a personal issue, I wasn't lying. And then I sat in with my GP, so he's like, right, what can I do for you? And I said, look, applying for medical school next year, I need work experience. And he was really, really nice. He said, right, come with me. So he pulled me along, went up to the admin team. He said, this girl is gonna come with and sit with me next week. She's gonna sit in with me for a couple of days and sit with another doctor for a couple of days and organize that for her. And because he was one of the partners of the practice, so he was one of the bosses basically, they were like, okay. And that's what I did. I ended up sitting with the reception staff as well, which was quite important, just to watch the way they answer the calls because they triage the patients as well. Working in a GP as an FY2, a couple of people also tried to do that, but my GP practice was a bit more strict with it because they were more wary of patient confidentiality. So you could be sitting in a consultation at your GP as a work experience student, and somebody you know could walk into that GP practice, and the fact that you know they've come into the GP that day for whatever reason it is, even though they ask you to sit out the room and you don't even hear what they've come in for, kind of breaches their confidentiality, if that's what makes sense. So I understand that most GPs use it as an excuse to not accept work experience students if they're registered at their practice. But that doesn't mean you still can't do that. So you can go to other practices, just walk in and speak to them face to face, or ask for the GP's email address or anything, or just go in there and be ruthless and be confident and say, this is what I want. Can I get a number? Can I get an email address? I'm really eager. Or if, for example, your GP says, you can't do work experience with me, trust me, he's got 101 different other GP friends, so ask him to direct you to their practice, maybe, to do that instead. Now, other places that you can go to are care homes and nursing homes. So care homes are places where people of care, mostly elderly people, but not always, that don't have many medical needs are looked after. It's basically like a residential home, which is quite different from a nursing home. So a nursing home is a place where people are looked after that have medical needs. So they either need feeding from a tube, they need hoist transfers, they just need medical input. And so they are manned more by nurses than carers. So you can go to either of them, and it's a really good opportunity to observe the work that they do, the struggles that they have, and also just the type of patients that they see, the social issues that they come across, the family dynamics of these patients, most common problems that they face medicine-wise, and just their interaction with a GP. So a GP often comes once a week to these care homes and nursing homes to do a round and see these patients. So that will be quite nice to observe as well. So that's basically a summary of all the types of work experiences you can get, the avenues you can go down, the people and places you can email and phone, and just, yeah. But remember that volunteering work and showing your skills in that aspect of things are much more important than work experience, if that makes sense. I just wanted to put a little pointer at the end of this video about what you should aim to get from your work experience. I have a lot of I have a lot of students who have done work experience and who I've read their personal statements over the years, and they boast about things like, I attended cardiothoracic surgery, I saw a triple bypass, and I was able to observe this kidney transplant. The fact is, nobody cares. And that is not what a doctor is about. That is not what you do in your day-to-day life. So instead of seeking out the thrills and the highs and the most extraordinary points of your experience, really hone in about the day-to-day activities of a doctor, their rota. If you are shadowing a doctor, say, can I have a look at your rota? Ask them about their salary, ask them about how many weekends they do, ask them about the most difficult situations they go through, ask them about difficult patients, and then also observe the interactions with doctors and other medical professionals. Remember, doctors aren't the only ones on the ward, and actually sometimes they're the least important person on the ward. You've got such a multidisciplinary team. So you've got nurses, physios, occupational therapists, you've got pharmacists, healthcare assistants, dietitians, speech and language therapists, like the list goes on and on. So have a look at the dynamics, have a look at the way they work together, and actually talk about that rather than this magnificent surgery that you watch, because nobody cares. So that's all for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully that was useful to you and you got a few pointers or some tips and tricks that you will apply. And if you have, then please let me know. Or if you are a medical student right now and you want to share other experiences that my viewers can benefit from, please pop them in the comments below. We'd love to read that. I want my channel to be about sharing experiences and helping people. I sound like someone at a medical school interview. Anyways, yes. Don't forget to subscribe, follow me on Instagram, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.